I'm Takanori Kato from Nippon Steel and Sumitomo Metal Corporation, Japan. I'd like to talk about critical internal defect size for subsurface crack initiation in heavy haul car wheel. Oh, sorry. Which button?
Probably need to direct in that direction. Just try to direct in that direction.
Oh, okay. Okay. This is the contents of my presentation. At first, I'd like to talk about the background. Oh, okay. Yeah. Okay, sorry. So, as you know, the shearing is one of the typical rolling contact fatigue damage in railway wheel, especially heavy haul car wheels. And there is there are two types of crack initiation in the shearing. The one is the surface crack, and another one is the subsurface crack. And mainly, subsurface crack initiate from internal defect, such as inclusions or voids, due to cyclic rolling contact. It is well known that defect size is much important for subsurface crack initiation. So the purpose of my presentation is to clarify the critical defect size for subsurface crack initiation. So we conducted a fatigue test for wheel steel with artificial defects and finite element analysis for actual wheel. And finally, we predicted the critical defect size by using fatigue test results and stress analysis results. Okay, now I'd like to explain fatigue test. We conducted the torsion and axial fatigue tests using round bar type test specimen. In order to evaluate the effect of defect size, we introduced the small hole at the surface of specimen. The diameter of small hole is 0.2 and 0.5 millimeter. And they are introduced by electrical diffusion machining. And the test material is AR Class C wheel steel for heavy haul car wheel in North America. Okay, I'd like to explain the test results. This graph shows SN curves of torsion obtained from torsion fatigue test. As you can see, the fatigue limit decreases with increase of defect size. And the crack origins are artificial defects, as shown in this photo. So this indicates that defect size much affects on the fatigue strength of wheel steel. Next, in order to evaluate the equations to calculate the critical defect size, we applied root area and EL-Haddad equations to the test results. So these graphs show the relationship between fatigue limit and defect size. The left side is torsion fatigue test results, and the right side is axial fatigue test results. You see here, both root area and Haddad equations can approximate it well to the test results, as shown in these graphs. So we can predict the critical defect size by using these equations, even if the stress barrier stress state. Okay, let's move on to stress analysis. In order to evaluate the stress variation at the subsurface, we conducted a finite element analysis for a 3/8-inch fluid curve wheel model. And there are two profiles in the model, new profile, not used, a new profile and a warm profile. And there are three steps in the analysis. So at first, we calculated the heat treatment situation to evaluate the initial residual stress state. And then we applied cyclic rolling contact with the new profile model. After that, we removed the, some elements corresponding to the warm area. And finally, we applied cyclic rolling contact again with warm profile model. And there are three different contact positions in this analysis: flange side, thread center, and front rim side. And the vertical load is equivalent to the wave load in AR specification. Okay, this is an analysis result. This figure shows an example of the shear stress distribution under contact loading. As you can see, the maximum shear stress appears at the south surface. So this indicates that the subsurface crust can be can initiate at the subsurface. And the right side graph shows the stress variation with the one cycle of rolling contact at the subsurface area. As you can see, the shear stress, this purple line, shear stress varied during the rolling contact. So this stress variation leads to initiate the subsurface cracks. And also, the normal stress varied with rolling contact. So this suggests that we should use the multi-axial fatigue evaluation model for evaluation of crack, subsurface crack initiation. And in this study, we applied a McDermid model, which is one of popular, famous multi-axial fatigue evaluation model. In this model, we used maximum shear stress range and maximum normal stress to the maximum shear stress plane, so this direction. And K is a material constant. We can obtain the constant from fatigue test results, as I explained earlier. And we evaluated the equivalent shear stress from these equations. This equivalent shear stress has the equivalent fatigue damage in the multi-axial stress state. So this graph shows the equivalent shear stress range in each contact position and average of them. So you see here, equivalent shear stress depends on the contact position or profile. But in the average shear stress, almost the same with between new profile and warm profile. So in this case, we assume that the frequency of contact position is almost the same in these three positions. So we can use the average shear stress to predict the critical defect size. Okay, finally, we predict the critical defect size. So this, as shown in this graph, so we estimated the critical defect size by using equivalent shear stress from stress analysis results, and these two lines obtained from fatigue test results, like here. And the right side table gives the estimation results. And as you can see, the average, by using average shear stress, we obtain the critical defect size as 1.1 millimeter in both new profile foil and warm profile foil. So this result suggests that we should reduce the internal defect size less than 1.1 millimeter to prevent the subsurface crack initiation. And the reduction of defect size is much effective to prevent the subsurface crack. This is my conclusion. Okay, I'd like to summarize my presentation. The fatigue limits decrease with larger defect in wheel steel, and the root area and yield hazard equations correspond well to the test result. And the critical defect size can be defined by our proposed technique, and the reduction of defect size is much effective to prevent subsurface cracks. Thank you for your attention.